building in the background and I'm going in there. I took pictures. There's looks like homeless right in front of, maybe living inside the building. There's just walking distance from there is this well manicured place called Edmund Dyke Missions. So there's that dilapidated homeless people and this well maintained Catholic facility here with this statue from Matthew, for I was hungry and you gave me something to eat. I was thirsty, you gave me something to drink. I was a stranger, you invited me in. I needed clothes, you clothed me. I was sick, you looked after me. I was in prison, you came to visit me. And look at the heart. But look right over here. And they're able to take care of this property in pristine condition that I'm standing on where the statue is and I'm reading. Right there, dilapidated building with homeless, and I could imagine hungry. They call it the Edmund Dyke Center of Hope, right here. The Edmund Dyke Missions ask that while you are in this sacred space, you join us in prayer for all those living in poverty, whom we are called to serve, and to remember the tens of thousands of benefactors from around the world who support and make our ministry and service possible. Well, I don't know. I'm still looking over here, and I've got pictures of the squalor conditions some people seem to be residing in a dilapidated, vacant building there, in this well-cared-for facility. Most of it, as you see, gated back there. Founded by two young Catholic priests, Father Francis Casey and Father John Barney Pyro, both members of the Society of St. Edmund in Selma, 1937. Well, they've maintained this very good, haven't they? Sacred Heart of Jesus. Devotion of the Sacred Heart of Jesus is a well-known devotion in the Roman Catholic Church, celebrating our Lord's divine love for all. On this statue, you'll see the Sacred Heart shining with divine light, pierced by a spear, encircled by thorns, surmounted by a cross. These symbols represent our Lord's death by crucifixion, but also the divine hope and grace offered by his resurrection. We invite you to contemplate the transformative power of the Sacred Heart of Jesus and join us in the following prayer. O most holy heart of Jesus, fountain of every blessing, I adore you, I love you, and with lively sorrow for my sins, I offer you this poor heart of mine. Make me humble, patient, pure, and holy, obedient to your will. Grant, good Jesus, that I may live in you and for you. Protect me in the midst of danger. Comfort me in my afflictions. Give me health of body, assistance with my temporal needs, and blessings on all that I do, and the grace of a holy death. Amen. Well, there you go. Right here. Dedicated, founded, July the 6th. Gospel. 2 days will be their anniversary. This is the 4th, 1937. Do the best we can with what little we have to serve those most in need. And guys, I hate to keep bringing that within walking distance here, but I'll add some of those pictures to this video, I think. And before I go, let's take a close look at the statue of Jesus, even though nobody knows what it looked like, and the heart right there. May you have heart.
Here on a bike ride, I had a little breakfast and I've ridden my bike over here. And we're just gonna take a walk for a minute. In fact, let me get rid of this helmet for sure. And then we're gonna take a walk. Peaceful cemetery here. Kind of just a block off of 31. Here in, I guess I'm in Pelham right now. God dang, can't get my helmet on. I wish you could see this. Got it. All right.
Cemetery here in Selma, Alabama. I want to give my respects to the highest elected official from Alabama, Mr. William Rufus Devane Keene, who was our 13th vice president under Franklin Pierce. A lot of interesting things about that gentleman, who many have not heard from. He's interred right in that little mausoleum, and the story goes that he was initially buried on his plantation somewhere outside of Selma here. Have not been able to find it. I'm sure it's been divided up and whatever. They say that his body was kind of stolen, and it was kind of moved here from there in the middle of the night. Moved here from there. I get it right. So anyway, I wanted to walk around here a minute. This is a interesting cemetery, and there's more to the story of William Rufus Devane Keene. If you'd like to find it, it's easily found, and I've done other videos on him. And this grass is high here. Gary, and they have look at these stones out here. The architecture. Oops, watch where I step. I'm not gonna spend a lot of time here, but just meander around a little bit in this very interesting cemetery. Somebody's done some damage to some of this stuff out here, unfortunately. Wow. But I wanted to come over here and take a look at this angel. James Hesketh. Ruth, children of James and Alice Franklin. And there's a lot more. Of course, we got the Confederate flags over here. I don't know if these people served in the Civil War. They're not. Let's see what this says. William Wells, 1837 to 1910. Very interesting, huh? You got to. I appreciate something like this. So spotted throughout here are some. These Confederate flags, not everywhere. Certain graves have them. Charles Word Hooper. Hoopers. Maud Philpott, wife of John Hooper. John Hooper. There's John Hooper. Yeah, this is interesting. It looks like somebody had put some cleanup on these. Clifford Belzora. 68 years old, died at my age, and died just short of a birthday by 11 days. And then look at these. Live Oak Cemetery, East Portion Reserved for Graveyard, 1829 West Park, purchased City of Selma, 1877. Here are buried William Rufus Devane Keene, 1786 to 1853, Vice President of U.S., 1853, John Tyler Morgan, 1824 to 1907, U.S. Senator, Brigade General CSA Edmund Winston Pettus, U.S. Senator, Arthur Hardy's Tactics, Episcopal Beast, Bishop. Walk across this little street that goes right in the middle here. This is really interesting here. It's been a while since I've been here. One of my favorite cemeteries to come to. And let's see. Yeah, look here. I can get up close and personal. So let's get around there. We go. This one is most interesting there. Drury Fair Jones, 1856 to 1878. Very young, huh? So that would be 22 years old, and I would say very much loved by her family. Drury Fair Jones. I don't know if that's in her likeness or that's just an angel. And then there's another one, same family, all behind this fence here. Okay, there's the whole breakdown of the family. Right on this stone here. And then, this is Sally A. Jones Featherston, 1854, 100 years before I was born. She was born to 1909. So I have to assume this was done in her likeness.
Thank you.
is down to 279. Who would have thought? Over July 4th. First time I've seen it below 280 in a few minutes. Ah, it's no big deal to me. I get like 70 miles to the gallon of gas on this here Helix. So I'm not complaining. My average fill up is around 5 bucks. And the ride is awesome. Ride in before the rain comes. I was gonna thought about going to Selma, but I didn't get an early enough start because we got a possibility of a little severe weather coming in this afternoon, another hour or two. So I'm gonna do the Selma run in just a couple of days. I hope today's Tuesday. Thank you.
Sometimes I turn my camera off when I come to a live like this. Leave it alone. Here we go. Nice.
Ivy Creek United Methodist Church caught my eye in Autauga County. Constructed 1854, part of the Mulberry Beat in Autauga County. Served the communities of Hamilton, Huckabee, Evergreen, Milton. Yeah, interesting, huh? So, I'm going to drive up here. Besides the sign, I'm not sure.